Yahweh. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the School of Intercession. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to the School of Intercession. I'm excited because the 30 days of prayer are flowing. Let me get this off of this commercial. 30 days of prayer are flowing, and we're on day 17. Day 17, 30 days of prayer. Day 17. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be unto God. Before we move into prayer, the Lord instructed me this morning to put on some purple lipstick, and I know that's at the box, and this is really not my color, but I'm gonna obey God, and I'm gonna tell you the symbolic of the purple lipstick and what it represents and what today means. What today means. Holy Spirit, name it Miracle Monday. Miracle Monday.
In Jesus, you are the great baptizer of fire. Oh, we need your baptism of fire. Come on. Just open up. He's just going to baptize you with himself. He's going to baptize you with himself. He's like, just come into me. Oh, he is fire.
So, the purple lipstick represents Christ's royalty with authority. Esther 1 and 6, Esther 8 and 15. So this purple lipstick is representing speaking from lips of royalty as a king will decree in the earth. So this morning, the Lord instructed me the first half of the prayer is to speak as his king and to decree from lips of royalty from the third heavens, the decrees of the Lord. One of the instructions that he gave me, even from Friday, he wanted me to do for Monday, was to speak blessings upon our children and our children's children. And all the blessings I will speak today is coming from the Word of God, Deuteronomy 28. Not only does God want us to war in the heavenlies for our children, But the Lord also wants us to speak the blessings of the Lord. He wants us to decree it and declare it on our children. So these utterances that the Holy Spirit is about to release through me, these utterances I decree this morning, is symbolic of being used as a prophetic mouthpiece to release the decrees coming from a holy, majestic, and royal king. So these are the Lord's decrees. It's coming from the word of God. These are the Lord's decrees. The purple lipstick represent that I am his prophetic mouthpiece. I am speaking his royal decrees over our children and our children's children. Now, as I told you, the color purple is very symbolic in heavenly places in the kingdom of God. Purple represents royalty with authority. When a king rules, he rules with his royal power and authority. Purple also represents kingship, majestic, royalty, mediator, creativity, reigning with Christ. So as we sit today, we are seated in heavenly places as kings and priests of the Lord, and we about to corporately come together, and we about to bless and speak God's kingdom over our children. This is Miracle Monday. Hallelujah. Now let me explain what a decree is so you can have some understanding as the Spirit of the Lord uses us to decree today. A decree. Kings releases decrees. There are so many scriptures in the Bible that talks about when kings decreed. So a decree is to release a judgment as a king commands. Is to give forth a command, a holder of judicial authority. This is the sentence of a king, and he gives a royal decree. So decree is a statement that carries the authority of a court order. So when a king decrees, it cannot be removed. So a decree is a command that is coming from the eternal king. Now I'm going to take you to a scripture that talks about decrees and from kings of the Lord. Okay, here's a decree in Daniel 6 and 25. Then King Darius wrote unto all people, nations, and languages that dwell all the earth, peace be multiplied to you. Daniel 6 and 23, I make a decree, this Daniel. I make a decree that in every dominion of my kingdom, men tremble and fear before the God of Daniel. For he is the living God and steadfast forever, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed, and his dominion shall be even until the end. So King Darius made a decree to his kingdom that every tribe had to tremble and fear the God of Daniel. So when a king makes a decree, it is a command. He released this over his whole kingdom. So the Lord want me to decree and declare blessings over our children this morning. And the difference between decree and declare, when we declare a thing, I'm just going to say this briefly. To declare is to speak as a spokesman, to make an announcement, or to report. But a decree is when a king releases a sentence or a command that's coming from a court order that's beyond the natural realm, but in the eternal realm, to the earth realm, and everything must come subject to the decree of King Jesus. So I'm going to simplify, that's the difference between a decree and a declare. So we're going to pray and we're going to decree and we're going to be obedient to the Spirit of the Lord. God not only wants us to speak the blessings of the Lord on our children, he wants us to decree that, but also we have to war as well. So let us decree according to the Word of God. Let's decree the blessings upon our children. Hallelujah. I decree the blessings of Deuteronomy 28 upon our children and children's children. I decree a spirit of full obedience and surrenders to Yahweh's will and holy statutes. I decree that they be blessed in the city and blessed in the country, that the fruit of their womb will be Holy Ghost blessed, and the crops of their lands, and everything they put their hands to be blessed by the Lord. I decree a supernatural invasion of increase be upon their baskets, bank accounts, the conditions of their souls, and their kneeling doors will be eternally blessed. They shall be blessed by the Lord when they go in, and blessed by him when they go out. The Lord himself will grant that the enemies who rise up against them will be defeated before them. They will come from one direction, but flee through the authority of heaven in the direction of Saturn. I decree and declare that the Lord will send a blessing on their barns and on everything that they put their hands to, according to the will of God. I speak the Lord will bless our children and children in the land that he has given them. The Lord will establish our seeds as his holy people, as he promised. I decree and legislate upon these souls to keep the commandments of the Lord Jesus Christ with the help of the Ruach HaKodesh Holy Spirit and walk in full obedience to Yahshua's voice and holy ways. I decree that the Messiah will be their God and they will be his people. Then the Lord will open up the heavens, the storehouse of his boundary, to send rain on their land in season and to bless all the work of their hands. The Lord will make them the head and not the tail, and they shall not turn to false gods, but they will serve the true and living God, Jesus Christ, through the infilling of the Holy Spirit all the days of their lives, in Yeshua's divine name, in Jesus' name, in the power of the blood, amen and amen. We just release a decree over our children and our children's children. According to Deuteronomy 28, we shall see this manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus. Now we're going to take some time and we're going to praise God. And then we're going to go to battle for our children. Hallelujah. As we have released the blessings of Yahweh, we decree and declare that it will come to pass. We will continue. We will fight the good fight of faith. Father, we bless you and we honor you, Father. Father, we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. Father, we thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, that your word will not return to your void, that you will accomplish, Father, everything that you send your word out to do, Father. We release heavenly Father in the name of Jesus, oh God, of praise, God. We praise you, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, the doing, oh God, Jesus, God, for pouring out your spirit, oh God, on our children, oh God. We thank you, Heavenly Father, God, for blessing our children, oh God, with the mind of Christ, God. We bless you and we praise you, God, for the blessing of Deuteronomy, oh God. We thank you, God, for a spirit of obedience, oh God. We thank you, God, for a spirit of holiness, oh God. We thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, that you are raising up a standard against the enemy, God. Father, we praise you, oh God. We glorify you, God. We magnify you, God. We exalt you, God. We exalt you as King, God. Father, when you decree a thing, oh God, it cannot be void. Father, we bless you and honor you, God, and we praise you, oh God, for the blessings that you have in store for our children. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Here come the best of you. release your royal decree. Release your royal decrees. Open up the gates. Oh God, I was so to you, but I was so. Oh God, Handeloso. Release your royal decrees. Oh Calabaroso, Yamaneroso. Father, we go up in the realm of the Spirit. Candeloso, Candeloso. You will allow the King of Glory, Candeloso, to release his royal decrees. Oh Calabaroso, Tia. We create an atmosphere here, Calaboso, Yamaneroso, Tia. Father, let your spirit Father, we begin to minister to our children. We decree and declare that this is, oh God, your atmosphere. We create an atmosphere for miracles to be performed on our children. And our children's children. We pray that they become attracted to Deuteronomy 28. That their minds and hearts will come will be stirred on you, God. We overflow. The mind of Satan. We cast down every demonic imagination. We cast down every seed of rebellion and deep hurt. My we pour down. Father, even secret sins will come. As we worship and we roar. Father, we worship and we roar. Father, all at the same time, that every place, that our feet shall tread, Father, you have given unto us, O God, Father, your ecclesy, and we take back territory, Father, we take back our children, we take back our grandchildren, as we worship and war, Father, we loose the blood, Father, we loose your power, we release heavenly Father in the name of Jesus. Father, that your glory shall be revealed. Father, I pray now in the name of Jesus, God. Father, for the condition, oh God, of our hearts, oh God, of the hearts of our children. Father, I'm asking in the name of Jesus, God. Father, for that you, oh God, to forgive the hearts of the children, the hearts of the parents, in the name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking, oh God, in mighty name of Jesus, Father, that you, oh God, will cause the parents, oh God, to become sober and alert, oh God, that you will cause the children, oh God, to no longer, God, rebel against their parents, oh God. Father, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, for a great awakening, oh God. I pray in the name of Jesus, God, for a major reset in the families, oh God. Father, for the enemy, God, comes in, oh God, to steal, kill, and destroy. But Father, I rebuke that pride and praying in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father, you came, oh God, that we may have life and life more abundantly, God. Father, I release, oh God, and decree, God, the blessings of the Lord, oh God. I decree and declare in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father, God, that we will fight the good fight of faith, Father. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, that the fire of the Lord, Father, will fall, oh God. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Father, that you will send your holy angels, oh God, Father, to make battle, God, on our behalf, oh God. I decree and declare, God, miracles that two people form, oh God. Father, I prophesy in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, and declare, God, miracles be performed in the heart of man and woman, oh God. I pray, God, for open surgery, and I pray, God, for great healing in the mighty name of Jesus. I uproot, oh God, every plot, plan of evil and wickedness, God. I overthrow, God, every malicious, oh God, plot from hell. In the name of Jesus, oh God. release, oh God, the King of glory. I release, oh God, the King of glory. Father, we set this atmosphere that the King may rule. We release this atmosphere that the King may reign. I release the King of glory. Father, have your way, God. Father, send King Jesus in, no God. Send King Jesus in, no God. Father, in every household of faith, God. Send the King in, no God. To the husband by the knee, to the wife by the knee, to the children by the knee, to the grandchildren by the knee. Father, I send the King of glory, oh God. Father, I ask, oh God, that you send the King of glory, that you send, oh God, the doctor, all physicians, oh God, that you send the one, God, that can cancel to the soul, oh God, that you send the one, oh God, and the bull, shake and the mother, oh, so too. My candidate, soto, God, that can remove every divorce decree, and the she, and the also. Father, send the King of glory. Father, send the King of glory. Father, we pray in the King of glory. Father, let our atmospheres, oh God, Father, to invite in the King of glory. Let there be an atmosphere of worship. Let there be an atmosphere of worship. Let there be an atmosphere of humility. Let there be an atmosphere of desperation. That King Jesus, oh God, that you are welcome, you are welcome, you are welcome. Solve every case, King Jesus. Solve every case, King Jesus. We bring every family to the courts of heaven, and we ask you, oh God, to be King and decree your verdict. We pray for mercy. We pray for mercy. We pray for mercy. We pray for mercy. But we ask you, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, to do whatever is necessary, God, to bring your family upon the family of God. Father, we ask, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you have your way, that you be King, that you release, oh God, the kingdom of God in our spirit. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus, God, that there will be a move of your power, a move of your spirit, Father. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus, God, that the enemy plans are now scattered, oh God. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus, God, that every tormenting spirit, Father, has been destroyed, Father. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, that your people, God, will walk in peace, God, that your people will no longer walk in confusion, oh God. We pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that all distractions be removed off of our young children, off of our young adults. Father, bring in your fire. Bring in your fire. Father, destroy the spirit of rebellion off our children. Destroy the spiritual pride out of our adults. Father, destroy the spirit of hatred and self-hatred and self-worship. Father, that our children, oh God, Father, trying to be their own God, trying to be their own God, Father, I'm asking you, Lord God, Father, to bring in a purging whip, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hold over the vessel. You come to the Lord, Father, bring in a purging whip. My candidate, Father, you said in your word, Father, that you discipline those that you love. You come to the Lord, Father, bring in the Landeroshi and the Lord, your spirit that purge, Landeroshi and the Lord, that cleanses on the inside. You come to the Lord, that causes, oh God, men and women, children of God, to come subject to your will. Father, let not our children be lost. Father, it's our decree and our prayer and our cry unto you, God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now, Father, we pray, God, in the name of Jesus, God, for the children, Father, that is up under a spell. Father God, that is being seduced, Heavenly Father, from the spirit, Father, of Jezebel, that is being seduced, God, by drugs, that's being seduced, God, by witchcraft, that's being seduced, God, by white magic and black magic. They're being seduced, God, by demonic powers. Father, we use the blood of Jesus over our ourselves. And Father, we put on the full armor of God that we can take our stand against the enemy, oh God. Father God, we, oh God, repent of our sins. And we ask God that you wash us and purify us, oh God. That you create in us, oh God, a clean heart. Father, let there be in the name of Jesus, oh God, no foul thing in us, oh God. That you may hear our prayer, Father. That our prayer, God, will not be, oh God, just a sound in your ear, Father. But God, that our prayer, God, in the name of Jesus, God, will reach your throne, oh God. And Father, that you will, oh God, release, oh God, your results in the earth as it is in heaven, oh God. Father God, we don't want Heavenly Father to move in the things of God and not bear not the love of Christ, Father. So Father, I pray that now in the name of Jesus, as we go up, Father, even higher in the realm of the Spirit, Father, to take authority, God, over every power, every, oh God, foul spirit, Father, has been dominating the minds and the hearts of the children, oh God. I'm asking you, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, to purge your wife, purge your bride, purge your wife. Hey, I never saw you, but I saw you, but I saw God. Father, cleanse us, oh God, with your word, Father. Wash us on the inside, oh God. Cause a spirit of submission, oh God, to fall upon the wife of Christ, oh God. Father, bring forth flesh, oil, oh God. Bring forth flesh favor, oh God. Bring forth, oh God, your wisdom in this season, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, I come to those. We come up against in the name of Jesus. Father God, every spirit, oh God, of Jezebel. Father, we put on our car the full arm of God. Father, I ask in the name of Jesus, oh God. Father, that you will send, oh God, the wind of your spirit. That you will send, oh God, your mind, oh God, over the children. And I'm asking God that you break Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus. Every, oh God, seed of Jezebel, every spell of rebellion. Father God, every spirit of delusion. Every spirit, oh God, that was sent, Father, to bring, oh God, bipolar and to bring drunkenness, to bring rebellion, to bring retaliation, to bring disobedience, to bring, oh God, the worship of self, Father. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Father God, that your fire will fall, God, in Jesus' name, God. I overthrow, God, the spirit of control. I overthrow mind control. I overthrow mind control. I rebuke Heavenly Father in the name of Jesus, oh God. The very mind of Satan. I am ashamed. I never thought to my candeloso. I never thought to my candeloso. Now, Father, I speak to the voices that's in the mind of the children. Hit candeloso. Father, that's in the mind of the adults. Father, I speak in the mighty name of Jesus to the voices. I command the voices of the Antichrist. I command the voices of the Antichrist. The voices that speak of death. The voices that speak of suicide. The voices that speak to kill and murder others. The voices that speak also to take vengeance in your own hands. I overthrow it in the mighty name of Jesus. I cast down every demonic imagination. Everything, oh God, that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. Father, I bring those thoughts captive into the obedience of Jesus Christ. Father God, I loose your blood. Father, I loose your sword. Father, I loose your healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking God that you heal my condition.
Father, I'm asking that you heal in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking that you heal in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking that you heal in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I'm asking in Jesus' name, God, that you bring minds back to you, Yahweh. That you bring hearts back to you, Yahweh. That you destroy the very plots of hell in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I glorify you, O God. I magnify you, O God. I bless you and honor you, O God. I give your name the glory, the honor, and praise, O God. We lose fire in the enemy's camp. Fire in the enemy's minds in the name of Jesus. We're going to take some time and we're going to prophesy to the children. We about to prophesy to the children. We about to speak the undebosoya. Meki undebosoti undeboshata. Mekandebosoto. Makandebosoto. Oh, it's time to go to war. Makandebosoto. Wenamandebosoya. Satan, makandebosata. Meki undebosia. As you are ruling in the second heavens. Hold up. The Spirit of the Lord, wars against you, I come to that wars against the saints' children, I'm dead. I call the seeds of the righteous, and I call the righteous in the blood of Jesus. Father, from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet, my candelaroso, that when the enemy sees the blood, my candelaroso, he will pass over, my candelaroso, when the enemy hears the blood, my candelaroso, the drops of the blood, my candelaroso, you will not have the body of Christ, Caesar. It can never be. you would lay your hands. Father, that you would lay your hands upon our seeds. Father, you said that before you put them in their mother's womb, that you already knew them. You already predestined them. You already called them to their purpose even before they was in their mother's womb. You already decreed, declared, legislated in the books of heaven what you had for them to do and what they shall do for the Lord. Father, we thank you, Father, that those words are still in heaven. We ask in God in the name of Yeshua that now, Father, you send the rain under the shop. We ask in God that you send the purging with my candelaroso. We pray now that you bring our family, our little city, our little child, Father, back to you, my little soul. For enough is enough. Father, our generation this day, this hour, this time, and now, Father, I'm asking, Father, for you to fill their hearts in the fear of the Lord. Father, break the demonic spells. Father, break the sorceries. Father, let them come out of covenant with the devil. Let every covenant be broken. Father, let them no longer entertain demons. Let them no longer talk to demons. Let them no longer be seduced by demons. Let them no longer have this father and do what the demons say do. Let them no longer blaspheme God. Let them no longer curse God. Let them no longer do things of God under the unction of unclean spirits. Father, we throw down Jezebel. We throw down Jezebel. Let the spirit know on the rules in the hearts of children in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, do a new thing. We reclaim our seeds to you. Only you, fathers, can get them off marijuana. Only you, God, can get them off the drugs. Only you, God, can restore their minds. We believe your word. We know prayer works. We know prayer real. We know, Father, that you got the power to bring forth the miracles today. Father, we're going to stay on the wall. I never said to you, so we're not going to give you no rest, God, until you restore them back to you. Father, that's your word in Isaiah. You told them, give me no rest. Stay on the wall day and night until I make Jerusalem the place that you intended it to be. Father, we give you no rest. Oh God, we give you no rest. We give you no rest, oh God. We give you no rest. We give you no rest, oh God. We give you no rest, oh God. He cut out of the no rest, oh God. He cut out of the soya. We give you no rest. He cut out of the soya. Until you, oh God, it kind of also fulfill your word. That's your promise, oh God. Snatch them from the fire. We snatched them from the fire. Through our intercession, we snatched them from the fire. We snatched them from the fire. Let a spirit of repentance fall. True repentance. God, a repentance that bears good fruit. Repentance that bears good fruit. Repentance that bears good fruit. Repentance that bears good fruit, Father. Send, oh God, your purging whip that brings a discipline in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, that the angels of the Lord that's assigned to our children, I ask God that you send them. Send the angels. Send the angels that's assigned to our children. Send the messenger angels. Father, do a work that the fear of the Lord come on them. Touch the hearts of the parents to not give up. Touch the minds of the parents to be still, Handerisha, and know that I am God. Know that I am God. Know, Handerisha, that I'm an expert, my Kanderisha, in dealing with difficult cases. I speak an upgrade in the parent's spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Heavenly Father, in the name of Yeshua, Father, I decree and declare now in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, that you will upgrade us, your people, Father, to flow, God, in the realm of faith, Father, to see the miracles of the Lord. Father, your word says that Jesus could not do many miracles in his hometown because, of God, there was an atmosphere of unbelief and little faith. Father, I'm asking you in the name of Jesus, God, to elevate your people. Father, elevate, oh God, our faith in you. Father, your word says, oh God, that we have faith as small as a mustard seed, that we can speak to a mountain, oh God, Father, through your royal lips. And Father, and watch it be moved because of the power that's in our faith. Father, I decree and declare, God, an upgrade in our faith. I ask you, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, God, to remove our doubt, to remove our weariness, to remove, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, every seed of worry. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, that when we worry, Father, that loses a hint of doubt. And Father, your word says that a double-minded man cannot receive nothing from God. So, Father, I'm asking in the name of Jesus, Father, for you to search your intercessors' hearts. Search the body of Christ's hearts. That when we enter in prayer, I ask Heavenly Father that you remove the seed of doubt. That you remove worry. That you remove distractions. That you remove weariness, oh God. Father God, I'm asking in the name of Jesus, God, that you will help us to cast all our care upon you because you care for us. And I'm asking God that we, oh God, will begin to flow in an atmosphere of faith, in an atmosphere of the supernatural, in the atmosphere, Father, that we speak, Heavenly Father, what is according to what's already done. So, Father, I'm asking God for an upgrade in the realm of the Spirit, that you will upgrade us, so God, to speak by faith, to speak by faith, to pray in faith, to minister by faith, to walk in faith, to walk in faith, to live in faith. Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that you remove, God, the spirit of doubt. That you remove, God, this doubt and this form of godliness. This form of being a believer. This form of being an intercessor. But yet, Heavenly Father, pray in doubt. But yet, Heavenly Father, utter up words, Father, that we, God, may not even believe. Father, I'm asking in the name of Jesus that you destroy this spirit called doubt. Father, I'm asking in the name of Jesus that we will all, Father, will build up our most holy faith in Christ Jesus. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you would deposit in us, so God, a greater wind of faith, a greater measure of faith. I pray, God, an upgrade in the realm of the Spirit. Father, that we will shift, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God, out of the flesh. Out of the flesh, man. Out of the flesh, God. Out of the fleshly world, Father. And God, that we will shift, God, in the realm of the supernatural. Father, that we will see, God, the things on your heart, Father. That we will see, God, what is written in your scroll and written in your book, Father. Written on your tablet, oh God. That you will write it on our hearts, oh God. And that we, oh God, will be able, God, to decree and declare and even pray, God, out of a spirit of pure faith. Yeshua. Father, you said that when we ask of anything, after we ask God, you command us to believe. You say believe after asking. Believe after asking. Believe after asking. Father, write this word on our hearts. That when we ask you a thing, that we believe. And then the Lord said, because we believe, we will receive when we ask for God according to thy will. Ask, believe, receive. Ask, believe, receive. Ask, believe, receive. Father, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we will come, O God, true believers. You want us to be true believers. You want us to be true believers. You don't want us lukewarm. You don't want us lukewarm, Father, because you said, O God, a lukewarm person, O God, you will spit out of your mouth. Father, we repent for lukewarm. We repent, Father, entering into your presence, not believing you. Enter into your presence, Father, leaving your presence and still got the worries and the cares of the world on our heart and mind. Father, forgive us. We are guilty, Father. We are guilty of that sin, oh God. Father, we come back as true believers. We come back, Father, to the mantle and the table of prayer as true believers. We come now, Father God, believing your word. Father, if you said it, you're going to do it. Father, we come back, oh God, believing the instructions that you have given us, oh God. If you said it, you're going to do it, Father. Father, we believe and we're going to receive, Father. Oh, Father, that you have to us and our seeds, Father. In the name of Jesus, Father, we get rid of the doubt today. No more doubt. Doubt cannot dwell in our temples. Worry, anxiety, and fear cannot dwell in our temples. God has not given us a spirit of fear. He has not given us a spirit of paranoia. He has not given us a spirit of worry. That's not part of our DNA. That's part of the flesh. That's part of the fleshly system. But we come in alignment. We come in total alignment, Father, to the will of our Father, which is in heaven. We come in total alignment, Father, to your will in the mighty name of Jesus. We come in total alignment, O God, to what thus saith the Lord. And we trust you, O God. We trust you, O God, as we enter into your presence. We choose to trust you. We choose to believe. We choose not to doubt. We choose not to worry. We know you're God. We know you're God. Nobody can do it unless you do it. Thank you for the new way. Thank you for miracles today. Thank you for miracles today. Thank you for miracles, E God, even in our hearts. Thank you for miracles today, giving us a heart of faith. Father, the lady with the issue of blood, she believed you. If I can just touch his garment, I will be made whole. And virtue left the Son of God. Healing left the Son of God. She was whole. Father, we have that type of tenacious faith. We believe you that radically, Father, for everything that we offer today in prayer. We believe you, Father God, that radically, Father, for everything that we are going to continue to ask in prayer. We're going to believe you, Father, that it's already done. As we ask, we believe, and we're going to see a miracle. Oh, this is Miracle Monday. Oh, this is Miracle Monday. I don't know what you was doubting today, but today, receive your miracle. I don't know what it is you were believing for so long, but today God says, believe me for the miracle now. He said, ask, believe, and receive your miracle. Ask, believe, and receive your miracle. Church, will see my miracle, says the Lord. You will see my miracle, says the Lord. You will see my answer, says the Lord. That I will do a great and mighty thing. If you only believe. Just believe. Just believe. God is shifting us to believe. God is shifting us to believe. God is ready to pour out miracles. Miracles. Now. Miracles are happening now. Miracles are happening now. Miracles are happening now, says the Spirit of the Lord. Hey! Glory to God. Oh God, we bless you for your miracles. We bless you, God, for the atmosphere of faith. We bless you, God, that angels are on assignment. We bless you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, that our faith help brought in the report of the Lord. Father, we thank you for dealing with the strong man called fear, anxiety. We thank you, God, for dealing with the strong man called pride, anderoso. We thank you, God, for dealing with the strong man trying to do it my way, anderosha. We thank you, God, for dealing, oh God, with doubt. And we're walking down God as little children. Childlike faith. Going to our Abba Father, crying on his lap, coming kneel and bow down to him, and we're giving it all over, and we're asking him to do some things as he requires us to do some things, and we're believing him, and God, we're going to see results. Father, we thank you for the manifestation. Father, I bless you in advance for the manifestation. I bless you, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, for the renewness of mine. I bless you for us, God, passing every test, God. I bless you, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, for doors, oh God, that no man can open but you, Father, that we just trust you for. We thank you, Father, for spiritual blessings, spiritual miracles. We thank you, God, for natural miracles. We thank you, God, for things that we need financially. We thank you, God, for things that we need for our children and our grandchildren. We thank you, God, for salvation. We thank you, God, for clothing our household, oh God, under the blood of Jesus. We thank you, God, for the raindrops of the blood. Father, we thank you for miracles today. We thank you for miracles today. We thank you, God, for strengthening, oh God, the church to be believers again. No more church as usual. No more praying as usual. No more interceding as usual. No more saying the things of God and using the word of God and don't have a fire or the presence of God. No more, no more, no more. No more, no more, no more. Uttering the word of God with no faith. Father, we trust you for your prayers of the righteous. It is your righteous. It is the prayers of the Holy Ghost. It is the prayers of the Holy Ghost that avail as much. It's not our righteousness. It's not our fire. It's not our authority. It's not our power. But God, we put all of our faith in the power of the Holy Ghost. We put all our faith in the power of the Holy Ghost. Father, we glorify you. Father, we magnify you. Father, we give you glory. We give you honor. We give you the praise. Oh, hallelujah. For we're now, God, a new spiritual man, and we live by faith. We live by faith. We walk by faith. We pray by faith. We in the realm where everything is already done. We don't fix our eyes, God, on what is seen. But what is unseen, oh God? We look, Father, with the eyes of the eternal realm, oh God. Father, our faith is in you, Father. We got confidence, oh God, that you have already done, oh God. We don't leave this prayer room, Father God, in fear. We don't leave this prayer room, Father God, in doubt. We don't leave this prayer room, Father God, wondering if God heard me. Wondering if God gonna do it. put our total confidence in you and in your unshakable word. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, God, for an atmosphere of the supernatural. God, oh God, that we're walking by faith and total reliance on God and total agreement with God. And we thank you, God, that your word will not return there, Father. We no longer, God, depend on our own human efforts. We no longer depend, oh God, on our own human efforts. Father, we depended on you. Thank you, God, for the miracles today. Thank you for the testimonies, oh God, that's unbreaking the Godhead glory. Thank you for a realm of glory. Thank you, God, for taking us out of ourselves and taking us, God, in Christ to function in faith. Thank you, God, for a new mantle of faithfulness, a new increase of wisdom of faith. Thank you, God, that the supernatural power of God is your divine intervention at work in the unseen realm. Father, you are performing miracles and wonders beyond human or fleshly capabilities. The supernatural relates to the hand of the finger of God being in our midst, doing extraordinary wonders that transition, that transcend, I meant, natural capabilities. This movement that you're doing, God, is beyond the embodiment of human wisdom, ability, or man natural strength. For the supernatural is released not by human might, not by human power, but by the Spirit of God Himself. These supernatural happenings, church, that's about to manifest, are unexplainable by natural laws or abilities, which are exercised by the divine power of God who perform miraculous wonders. Father, we bless you, we honor you. We thank you, God, for the faith that Peter walked on water. We thank you, Heavenly Father, God, for the faith that you're giving us today. We thank you, Father, that signs and wonders shall follow those that believe. That in your name, Father, we shall do great and mighty exploits. But, Father, we shall not only do it in faith, but, Father, we shall do it in faith in the Son, not in ourselves. Father, no more self-efforts when we lay hands. No more self-efforts when we pray. No more self-efforts when we worship and miracles manifest. Father, we refuse to be a people that's religious. We refuse to be a people, Father God, that's doing works out of self. Father, shift the church. Shift us to Heavenly Father, to the right teachings. Shift us, God, to be under right teaching, that we can function out of faith in the Son of God and no longer focusing on self-efforts. No more self-efforts. No more self-efforts. Our focus now. We repent, Father. No more self-efforts, but God is now. Our faith is in the Son that is at work in us. He brings glory through us to Yahweh. Holy Spirit, bring glory to the Son. So, Father, we just thank you and we bless you. We cover and seal this prayer and the people of God under the blood of Jesus. No weapon formed against us, it shall not prosper. And I just pray today that you all wake up every morning creating an atmosphere of faith. Put a shield around yourself and your families. Loose the blood of Jesus. Pray a covering. Go into heartfelt repentance. And we know again that repentance is not confession. People can confess a lot of things. I cheated on my income tax, but still do the same thing the next year. I didn't pay my tithes, but still do the same thing at the next time. It's time to pay tithes. Repentance is a change of heart and a change of mind. It's a mindset shift. It's a shift in the mind. That's what repentance is. It's when you confess that from your heart, your mindset now shifts into the mind of God.
that you are no longer dependent on yourself. You just yield with a helper called Holy Spirit. You yield to Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit help you, listen, as you trust him. He can be trusted. As you trust him, listen, and then put your faith 100% on him. God, I can't make it happen. God, I can't do this with my spouse. God, I can't do this over the assignment or the community that you've given me. God, you called me to feed the homeless. God, you called me to do this. Put all of your faith now on Holy Spirit. Get out the way. No more efforts. Just yield and do your part. If he tells you to go speak to somebody, trust the Holy Spirit that he's the one that's going to convince them. You don't have to be their personal Holy Ghost. Get self-effort out of the way and move in faith in the Holy Ghost. Move in faith in the Holy Ghost. Now, I'm telling you, when we live a way like this, miracles will become normal. The manifestations of our prayer life will be normal. Will be normal. Now, this will also cause an attraction from the second heavens, because he's not going to let you operate like that. Let me tell you something. The devil don't mind none of us operating in the gifts of the Spirit when we are promoting ourselves. When he know, oh, they copying what I want them to do. But when you begin to have a renovation of the mind, get under the right teaching. Get under the Holy Spirit's teaching. Get under the cloud of the Ruach HaKodesh so he can teach you and me how to truly function in faith, how to function in the spirit realm, how to function as a prayer warrior. You will get the results of the third heavens. So God, I bless God for this. I bless God for the teaching. I didn't even know that the Holy Spirit was going to speak of that. I bring that out. Even the teaching that he just shared was new to me. So God want us to focus on giving faith to the Holy Ghost. Amen. And when we do that, get ready for the second heaven. You're going to have to know how every morning. Atmosphere of faith, true repentance, shifting the mind. That's what it is. It's a shifting in the mind. After the confession, I'm shifting to the mind of Christ. The blood of Jesus, and loose a hedge and go forward and do your assignments in faith. God bless you. God love you. Thank you. And we just decree today, Miracle Monday. We decree today, when you leave this prayer atmosphere, you left everything. Whatever was going on, whatever was on your heart, you left it with him. You act, you believe, now you're about to receive a miracle. And listen, put 100% faith in Holy Spirit. Not in the person that prayed. I'm going to say that again. Not in the person that Holy Spirit used to pray. Not in yourself. We come into right teaching. We put in the faith of Holy Spirit. He won't disappoint us. Amen. Long as we line up to everything he said. And we know there's some things that can hinder our prayers. So we got to make sure iniquity is not in our heart. But as you truly seek God, he'll reveal to you. Get this out. Do this, do that. And then just flow with him and put your trust in him. God bless you. I already feel a shift. I already sense miracles. I already sense that Jesus has released royal decrees. And guess what? My faith ain't in me. My faith ain't in you. My faith is just in Holy Spirit. Not just in Holy Spirit, but in Holy Spirit. That's who my faith is. And guess what? I'm going to receive the miracle that I'm waiting on. in manifestation in the earth as it is in heaven, it has and will manifest. God bless you. May you leave this prayer line today in the peace of God. And as a true believer, one whose faith now is totally in Holy Spirit, rest. Rest, son. Rest, daughter. We can't do nothing unless the Holy Spirit is involved. God bless you and have a miracle Monday. In Jesus' name, amen.